You've defeated me, Lydia. Go on home, stop hiding. I won't come pursuing you about the countryside any longer. You're free and rid of me, Lydia. You could look happier about it. Well, so be it.
Marcus. Oh, Marcus, you know I don't hate you.
Lydia.
Oh, Marcus, Marcus. Oh, this is the beauty I knew.
You'd have known it had to happen when I watched you leave the gathering.
You were there?
Yes. I should have known what I really wished. You with me always as my wife. Will you do that, Lydia? Will you give me the greatest triumph a man ever had? Be my wife?
Oh, yes, Marcus.
Now, gather up what you need and let's be gone from this gloomy den. Hurry.
Yes, Marcus, I'll hurry.
We'll go to Antium. Petronius will outdo himself. A ceremony and wedding feast such as never has been seen. And even that will be lost moments.
Oh. Marcus, Paul will be here soon. I would like so much to ask his blessing and perhaps let him say the words over us.
What words? You've heard enough of his words. They've deafened your ears to everything life has to tell you.
But you heard Peter and Paul speak. Did you hear anything that was ugly or wrong?
I heard a childish old man speak in riddles. Believe as they do, and you'll think a cow is a bull, and a bull is an ox, and an ox is a goat.
Oh, Marcus, dear. I thought, having heard, you might begin to know. To understand why.
Yeah. Is this the symbol of your God? Your Christ?
The cross on which he was crucified.
I'm willing to accept your God if it makes you happier.
I don't demand it.
In our gardens in Sicily, we'll put up a big cross, higher than the roof. More than that, I'll put up a special pedestal and crown it with a figure of your Christ, carved from the finest marble. Of course, you'll have to have Peter tell the sculptor what he looks like.
Marcus, listen to me.
Why not? It's no trouble. There's such an army of gods these days, we can always find room for another.
I'm not asking it as a condition of our having one another. I just hope and pray that one day the image of Christ will appear in your heart.
My heart is only for you. There won't be room for him there.
There will be. I always carry him in mine, with you.
Well, take him out if he means that much, Lydia. You hear me? Get rid of him.
Well, I'm glad to see you on your feet again. Last night and this morning, you had us quite concerned.
Paul, Marcus has just asked me to be his wife.
Oh, I'm sure that this has brought her great joy, Marcus.
You could see, Paul, that I loved him. I was just trying to explain to him that, well, that there are other things. I mean...
I understand.
I don't. I offered to accept the symbols of her God into my house. I don't ask her to accept mine. What more can I do or say to prove that I'm not an enemy of her God?